I am a proud bisexual woman. It is not an accomplishment. I woke up like this. Whenever I tell people that I am bisexual, they respond very much the same way they do when I tell them that I'm a nurse. They're like, "Oof, wow. Not for me, but good for you. Good for you. Yeah. How long have you been doing that? Really? Wow. I could never, but good on you. Good on you." As a bisexual person, I do have a type, and it is people with knuckle tattoos. Because they look like they can really finger bang, if you know what I mean, right? Like if the hamburger helper hand had knuckle tattoos. It would be over for me, you know? Fake tits, real beef. In my head, that's what the hamburger helper's knuckle tattoos would say. As a bisexual woman, I get a lot of straight women who come up to me, especially when they're drunk, and they say things to me like, "You know, I've always thought that I might like having sex with a woman, but I don't think I'd be very good at it." Ah! And they're right. They wouldn't be. You really want to blow a straight woman's mind, and you tell her that going down on a woman, not even the most difficult part of having lesbian sex, right? No. It's putting on a strap-on, all right? And I'm not talking about the hip thrusting back and forth motion. We can all fucking do that, okay? I'm talking about physically putting on the strap-on harness and adjusting the buckles and snaps and zippers and clips and O-rings, and I don't know which way is up. If I didn't know any better, I think a plus-size clothing designer made this thing, right? The whole thing is a lot of pressure, right? It feels like your very first day of trapeze school. But you also have to fuck the other person. And once you do get that thing on and come out of the closet or bathroom or wherever you are, because you are not doing that in front of somebody. No. No, you need a good 25 minutes of solitude to get it all adjusted, see what you're doing, and give yourself a pep talk, right? You gotta be like, "All right, I'm confident, I'm sexy, this looks totally normal, it's orange." Once you do finally get down to business, you can't feel a damn thing that's going on, right? Because it's not really attached to you. It's kind of like doing the hokey pokey, but your foot fell asleep, you know? You're putting stuff in. And you're taking stuff out. And you're moving stuff all about. You have no idea if it's doing anything. So in my experience, the sound of two lesbians having sex is much less macaroni in a pot and more two people asking each other, "Is it out again?" "Yeah, it fell out again." "Is it out again?" "Yeah, it fell out again." Till they both just give up and cuddle instead. Super fulfilling. It's